Okay.
And in the blue corner, the return of amateur boxing club, John McNally.
On the bell, yeah?
James, well done. That looked like it was a bit of a cruise for you.
Yeah, to be honest, I did my hard work yesterday because I boxed number two, England's number two. So I've done my hard work, I said, and that was more of a cruise. I'm not being big-headed, but a cruise, I said, it's like to tick over, really. I'm not being big-headed, like, but, yeah.
Looking ahead to the final, you must feel reasonably confident about taking the time.
I'm so confident, honestly. Two-time ABA champion at 19, I said, honestly. I'm looking to do it, definitely.
Looking further ahead to the Commonwealth Games, you've got a good chance now of being selected to box for England.
Definitely, I beat the number two, do you know what I'm saying? So it looks like hopefully I'll book my place in the Commonwealth, just winning there, do you know what I'm saying? Hopefully.
We'll hope for the best for you. Well done again.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Joe is 21, been boxing for 8 years, comes out of the Rotunda ABC. His club coach is Nick McAllister. Joe has won 29 bouts out of 36. In the blue corner from Kirkdale, Liverpool, 21-year-old Joe McNally.
Nothing to choose after the first round between Tony Hill from Southampton, all in red here, and the man all in black with the blue headguard and blue gloves, Joe McNally from the Rotunda Club in Liverpool, one of three from that club in action here so far this evening, and who came through a very tough quarter-final yesterday against Callum Johnson, winning by just a single point. And I wonder how much has that taken out of McNally as we move into the second round here in the second semi-final at middleweight.
Both trying to figure a way out of scoring now.
both being cagey. McNally lands there with a right hook. Just got to be a little bit more aggressive, McNally, off heel. Get in and get out. That's better.
McNally gradually winning the battle of the jabs here from centre ring. Two southpaws in action here, both leading with the right glove and the right foot, with the power punches coming from the left hand further away. Good work. Two-punch combination from McNally.
That's better work from McNally. He's just got to get in and get out, land his shots and then get off to the side.
And word travels around ringside of the score here. It will be known by many of McNally supporters. They will tell him that he's in the lead. The corner will be towed at the end of the round, and he can build on his confidence here. Terrific left hand over the top, but he does take one back as well. And now this contest really beginning to warm up.
Good shot from Tony Hill there. Looking for that right hook again. There's the left hand as well. This is better from Hill. He's just got to get busy now, maintain it.
Developing this into a fascinating contest between the right hand landing sharply from Joe McNally and the left cross from Tony Hill. Yeah, the right jab again from Joe McNally from the Rotunda Club, but he's being met virtually punch for punch here by Tony Hill from the Golden Ring Club in Southampton, and a terrific contest here at the halfway stage. This could go any way.
Silver Fox Gill. Out of 64 bouts, Tony has won 54. His best result, gold in the Junior Olympics in 2002. In the red corner, from Southampton, 19-year-old Tony Hill.
Is evolving into the most competitive, intriguing affair of the evening so far between Tony Hill, all in red here from the Golden Ring Club in Southampton, and the local lad from the Rotunda Club, Joe McNally, all in black with the blue headguard and blue gloves. Two southpaws leading with the right hand, and a classic clash of styles this has been, with McNally tending to score with the jab and Hill with the follow-up left hand over the top.
I just feel that Hill needs to be a lot busier. When he lets his shots go, he comes back that right hook. He looks very impressive, but then he goes to waiting for 10 seconds, 15 seconds. He needs to let his hands go.
A burst of applause around this Olympia Theatre every time McNally lands with anything remotely significant. McNally all in black here, looking remarkably sharp considering a very tough quarter-final less than 24 hours ago against Callum Johnson, which he won by a single point, and he lands a hook come jab high on the head of Tony Hill, and the gap between them now moves to 6 points, and this looks to be a winning lead for Joe McNally now. As long as he doesn't rush in, leave himself wide open, make any rash mistakes from here on.
This is better from McNally. He's got his rhythm going now. He's pulling ahead on the scorecards, and he seems to be taking over. Hill's got to come back at him. He can't let him dictate things the way he's dictating. But this is good work from McNally.
Yep, starting to look more composed now. He clearly feels he's got the measure of Tony Hill with just over a round to go. And the crowd are loving this one because McNally has forged his way into a 7-point lead here. And those who know their amateur boxing understand that that is really difficult, nigh on impossible to turn around in a 2-minute period.
Good round for McNally, that was, real good round.
Just a reminder that the highlights.
And there's the man waiting to face the winner of this contest in the final of the middleweight championship here, James DeGale, impressive winner of the first of the semi-finals. Here, McNally. Again, throwing some very sharp punches. And much the busier against Tony Hill. It's the sheer volume of punches that really has been the difference between the two from Joe McNally.
Tony Hill. And in the blue corner from Kirkdale, Liverpool, 21-year-old Joe McNally. fourth and final round.
So Joe McNally has what looks like a winning lead here. The man all in black from the Rotunda Club in Liverpool, leading by 10-3 after three rounds in this clash of southpaws. He's been much the busier and has landed the more clinical punches throughout the first three rounds. Forging forward with that double right jab, trying to break down the defences of Hill, and he's been successful on many an occasion.
See, with McNally, he sometimes rushes in and bundles in, but he's a lot more skillful than people would think. These hooks and that, he knows exactly what he's doing. He sways his head to avoid punches. It's very clever what he's doing, and he's dictating the whole fight against a real good boxer in Tony Hill.
Tony Hill standing on the back foot, content to let McNally come at him, but if you're going to fight that sort of style, Rob, you've got to be razor sharp. The reflexes have got to be lightning fast.
And you've got to let your hands go. He's got to punch in combinations behind his straight shots. But credit to McNally, he's not allowing him to do that. He's slipping and swaying, and he's bombing him with hooks, and he's slipping off to the side. And, you know, he's dictating the fight, and he's winning the fight.
And from centre ring, McNally has planted himself there virtually from the start and said, this is where I'm going to boss the contest, and that's exactly what he's done. Another good combination from Joe McNally. Those two and three punch combinations have been the difference between the two. And the speed as well. He's been first to the punch time and again, and Tony Hill for much of the contest has been caught flat-footed. So victory for Joe McNally, another success for Liverpool, coming through after a tough quarter-final 24 hours earlier, and now takes another step towards that ABA title that he's promised everyone around here that he's going to win someday.
Show your appreciation for both boxers, please.
There we saw the kind of work that brought victory for Joe McNally. Impressive, speedy clusters, which Tony Hill couldn't respond to in the main.
The results of bout number 13, with a point score of 4-11, the winner McNally in the blue corner. Show your appreciation for both boxers, thank you.
So Joe McNally goes forward to a showdown with James DeGale in the middleweight final, and as impressive as DeGale was in his semi-final, he knows he'll have plenty of work to do to keep this man at bay in the final.
Bout number 14 is an 81-kilogram semi-final in the red corner, representing the Royal Navy, Sean McDonald.
All right, to sit down there then.
Yeah, mate, go on and have a seat for a minute.
And in the blue corner from Sunderland Boxing Club, Tony Jeffries. Red MacDonald, Blue Jeffries, referee Mr. Greg Cannell.
Hey lads. Yeah.
Yeah, when you're ready.
Okay, here we go, Joe. Joe, congratulations. That was a great fight. That was the noisiest it's been in here all night. Did that help?
Thank you. Yeah, with the crowd behind you, it helps a lot. It pushes you on to win the fight a lot more. So it pumps your adrenaline up. So felt good, like, you know what I mean? I've won, and that's the main thing. That's what I'm buzzing about.
Next up, the finals. James DeGale, your opponent, should be a tough fight.
Yeah, it's nothing to worry about. Let him worry about me. So he's got all the worries in the world, not me. I'm a bunch going there to win, and that's it.
You seem to be pretty relaxed. No pressure on you, despite all the attentions from your friends and family.
Well, I've got a good gym. Spar better kids than DeGale. So I've got no worries, really. I'm prepared. I'm prepared for these. Not better than the Ritunza, that's the one.
It's Liverpool seems to produce good kids. What is it that's different about Liverpool that can make that happen?
Well, it's just an amazing city, isn't it? It's an amazing city. You've got the Ritunza, the Salisbury, the Kirkdale. There's a lot of gyms, isn't there? So, all to thrive an area and just happy to be from Liverpool.
How did you first get started in it?
Just went along the gym to lose a bit of weight, to be honest with you. I was chubby as a kid, so I went along, and then it just went from there. Then lost the weight, got stuck to it, picked it up, my hobby, and I love it. And that's it. Cracking on now. Hopefully, Commonwealth Games next year.
We wish you the best with that, and we're with the final, and well done again.
Okay, thank you. Thanks a lot. Thanks.
Well done, Joe. Good.
The result of bout number 14, the referee having stopped the contest in the first round, the winner Jeffries in the blue corner. Show the appreciation for both boxers. Thank you. Doctor to the ringside, please. Doctor at the ringside, please. Right, bout number 15 is an 81-kilogram semi-final. Introducing in the red corner from the Kingfisher Boxing Club, Mark Redhead. And in the blue corner from Kirkdale Amateur Boxing Club, Joey Ainscoe. It's red, 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 blue Ainscoe. Referee, Mr. Andy Fisher. Thank you.
Semi-final at light heavyweight, around 12 and a half stone, featuring two familiar rivals here. Mark Redhead from the Kingfisher Club in Great Yarmouth, all in black with the red headguard, and the man in the white vest with the red strap is Joe Ainscoe from the local club Kirkdale, the champion in 1999 when he beat Redhead on that occasion, but that decision was reversed in the championships last year. And so Ainscoe looking for revenge here. Mark Redhead, 32 years of age, began boxing before many of tonight's contestants were even born, 21 years ago, representing tonight the Kingfisher Club in Great Yarmouth.
Cagey start from both boxers here. Ainscoe the orthodox.
We've seen this a lot tonight, Rob, haven't we? A cagey start by both men, as if they're determined not to give anything away in these early stages, being just one step away from the final.
Yes. Started cagey, and as the fights have gone on, the fights have got heated. And
often the man who's decided to take the initiative has gone on to win.
Has won the fight. Whoever's led off, initiated the actions, ended up winning the fight in most of the cases.
First decent punch of the contest landed by Mark Redhead, but not rewarded on the scorecard, although he is belatedly. So he creeps into the lead as we move into the closing stages of this first round. The first semi-final at light heavyweight. The winner will meet Tony Jeffries in the final. Jeffries, an impressive stoppage winner over Sean McDonald in the first of the semis. Both men warned by the referee for holding, and the command on break is to take one step back before the action recommences. And a standing count there for Joe Ainscoe from the Kirkdale Club. Good shots again from Redhead. Ainscoe is not happy about it at all, but it will just register that single point on the scoreboard. At the end of the first round, Redhead just eases into the lead. And there was that razor sharp ramrod right hand over the top, over the lazy jab of Joe Ainscoe. He complained to the referee, but he did rock back on his heels. We've seen punches like that landing in earlier contests this evening that didn't warrant standing counts, but each referee to his own, and Redhead leads by 2-1. Fairly leisurely opening, this has the makings of a terrific contest here at light heavyweight between Mark Redhead, all in black here with the red trims and the red headguard, against the man in the predominantly white vest, Joe Ainscough from Kirkdale. They've met twice before with one win apiece, and Redhead the narrow leader after that first round, courtesy of a terrific right hand over the top towards the end of the round, which forced a standing count on Ainscough.
Redhead started the busier fight area. Ainscough needs to pick up his work now, start putting his punches together.
And again, that right hand from Redhead. This time Ainscough had begun to see it coming and started to duck out of the way, but that is clearly going to be something he's going to have to look out for over the course of the next 2.5 rounds. Ainscough now trying to press forward, trying to grab the initiative. Still just a single point between them, but Redhead, the older man, 32 years of age, still leading. And another good shot there as Ainscough rushes in.
In these close cagey rounds, it's whoever's the busier. Whoever's the busier fighter nicks the odd point. Before you know it, the 3 points ahead. Ainscough's got to get working here. He's let Redhead get into a good rhythm and he's got to start responding.
Just signs with half a minute to go in this second round that Ainscough is getting a little wild now, starting to get a bit frustrated, trying to claw back this deficit, which still stands at just a single point as Redhead works away to the body before the referee tells them to break and to stop holding. You get the feeling, Rob, that a single shot here could turn it round. Not necessarily a knockout shot or even a shot that forces a standing count, but can just sway the fight one way or the other.
They've got to let them right hands go with them both being orthodox. You only got to score a point, then two with the right hand and you're ahead and you can sail home.
In the blue corner, Joe Ainscough. Joe is 25, from Liverpool. He's been boxing 14 years, comes out of the Kirkdale at ABC. Slim coaches, Chris Kane.
Mark Redhead trying again with that right hand over the top, but on that occasion, Ainscough saw it coming. And this time, Ainscough came forward, feinted with the right hand, lunged forward with the left uppercut, just about on target, and rocked Redhead back on his heels. But unfortunately for Ainscough, it didn't score.
Joe Ainscough.
Two rounds to go and still all to play for in this second semi-final at light heavyweight. Between Mark Redhead, virtually all in black with the red headguard, and the blue headguard, predominantly white vest of Joe Ainscough from the Kirkdale Club in Liverpool, a clubmate of Neil Perkins, who's in China at the moment producing one of the performances of the year in amateur boxing in reaching the medal stages of the World Championships. Ainscough, the champion in 1999 at this light heavyweight division, and trying to repeat the feat here, but he's got to get past Mark Redhead first, the man who blocked his passage to the final in the championships last season. Redhead beaten in the final by David Pendleton, and quite convincingly at that.
This is better from Ainscough. He started this round a lot more busier. Nicked himself a point. One ahead now. He's got to start picking up his work and try and forge ahead. Not let Redhead dictate what he was allowing him to do in the first couple of rounds.
A bit more snap about the work of Joe Ainscough, and he's beginning to see more clearly those punches coming from Redhead. But once again, it pulls level as Redhead works away inside. As Robert McCracken was saying, the key here is to just keep working, be busy, in the hope that one or other of your punches will land, will catch the eye of one of the five judges sat at ringside. Ainscough goes to the body this time, lands with a terrific right hand to the body, but those are the shots routinely which don't score on this new computerized system, because not enough. Not three of the five judges can see it clearly enough. Ainscough busily working away at the end of this third round. beautiful left hook as Redhead comes forward, and that extends the gap to 3 points at the end of this third round, and that could be crucial in what is such a close-cut affair.
In the red corner, Mark Redhead. Mark is 32 for Norwich.
Redhead there coming forward, motioning to throw the right hand, but walks on instead to a crisp left hook from Joe Ainscough, who had his best round of the contest in the third.
Mark has had 98 pounds, 170, twice AEA senior finalist, 9 times Eastern County champion. From Norwich, in the red corner, Mark Redford. Fourth and final round. Redford, Redhead in the red corner.
Joe Ainscough in the white vest with the red strap here and the blue headguard, on the verge of continuing a terrific night for Liverpool here. He's the sixth Liverpudlian in action so far this evening. All five previously ended up winners.
Yeah, Joe Ainscough started off very slowly here tonight, but round three was a particularly good round for him. And round four, he's carried on where he left off, dictating things, bundling in, working, forging ahead, and he's timed it right. He's saved himself for the last couple of rounds, and he's pulled away.
Absolutely, he had a good win in the quarterfinals less than 24 hours ago, and is now keeping up the good work here. It was nip and tuck for the first 2.5 rounds or so, but Ainscough then pulled away in that third round. And now it's just a case of consolidating that lead as we come to the final minute of the contest. And Ainscough here looking set to take revenge on the man who beat him in the ABA Championships last year and then went on to lose in the final.
Still not
Ainscough
too much
now
scoring.
Clearly buoyed by the crowd as well, Rob, even though there's not much scoring punches going on. Ainscough is still the busier.
Yeah, he's far busier. Round three and four, he's turned the fight round for me. Redhead was in control the first two rounds, but he's in control of things now. Scored another couple of points there, and he's run out a good winner, but I just wish he'd have started a bit quicker.
Since that quiet first round, though, Ainscough has paced himself well here. He's done just enough to win, and he's got 2 weeks respite now to freshen up for the final against Tony Jeffries. And that will be a tough one, judged on Jeffries' stoppage win in the first of the semi-finals against Sean McDonald of the Navy. And now the two boxers just being separated again as the referee takes a look at a slight nick on the cheekbone of Joe Ainscough, but that won't be enough to concern him or the referee, with only a few seconds to go. And Ainscough makes his way through to the light heavyweight final and a chance to add to his victory in the ABA Championships of 1999.
Show the appreciation for boxers, please.
And here we see action that really reflects the contest as a whole. Both men coming together, throwing lots of punches, but few of them landing with any real venom. But the busier man, as he showed there with that uppercut just sneaking through the guard of Redhead, Joe Ainscough, and a deserved winner.
The result of bout number 15, with a point score of 10-4, the winner Ainscough in the blue corner. Show your appreciation for both boxers. Thank you.
It was close for a while, but in the end, Ainscough pulled away for a fairly comfortable victory, and he goes forward to meet Tony Jeffries in the final at light heavyweight.
Bout number 16 is a 91 kilogram semi-final. Introducing in the red corner from the Royal Navy, Mick O'Connell. And in the blue corner from Wellington Amateur Boxing Club, Nathan Thompson. It's red O'Connell, blue Thompson, your referee, Mr. Andy Fisher. Thank you.
Yep.
That's great. Just a bit level on the mic.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, here's Joe Ainscoe.
Yeah, they're happy with that.
Okay.
And they're rolling, yep.
Joe, well done. It was a pretty tough fight, but you sort of pulled away towards the end.
Yeah, I knew it was going to be a tough fight. I fought Mark Red Dead earlier this year in the ABAs, and strong, big strong lad, keeps coming. Hits him with anything, you know what I mean? He won't stop coming, he's experienced lad, so I knew I was in for a tough night, but I was wanted to stick to my boxing mode and get involved in a scrap. And that was the telling point, and a couple of extra points, you know what I mean?
Lots of noise in here tonight. I mean, it's a great atmosphere when you're fighting at home. How much does that help?
Yeah, well, when I boxed him last time, it was in his hometown, you know what I mean? So that got lost on a count back with all my family here and my girlfriend or my little brother, everyone. So it makes a fight all the more, makes a battle harder, you know what I mean?
Liverpool's a great city for producing plucky youngsters, particularly in this sport. What do you think it is? What's the magic ingredient here?
I think it's a bit rough around here. So people are brought up hard, you know what I mean? No one has it easy. Not everyone's got money and people have to struggle. I think that it breeds toughness into people, you know what I mean? I think somewhere we had a lot more money, more posh district, you wouldn't get as many tough fighters.
Definitely not.
How did you first get into it? What was your real incitement to get involved in boxing?
My dad suggested it to me. I was only 8 when I first ever went in the gym. A few of us met, me older brother, a couple of my cousins, but I just loved it from the very start, and when they all dropped off after a few weeks, I stayed from while I was 8 and I've boxed every season since. Well, since I had my first fight at 11 and I haven't missed a season since. I've boxed every year since then.
Good, well, you deserve some success and we wish you the very best for the finals.
Thanks very much, thanks.
Thank you very much,
Joe. Cheers, mate. Thanks, mate. In the red corner, Mick O'Connell. Mick is 31 from Newport in Shropshire. He's been boxing for 14 years. Boxes out of the gym on HMS Nelson in Portsmouth, boxing tonight for the Royal Navy. Club coach, Q Shillingford, and out of 105 matches, Mick has won 88. His best result, ABA champion 2003, silver medalist in the Commonwealth Games in Kuala Lumpur in 2003 also. In the red corner from Newport, Shropshire, boxing for the Royal Navy, 31-year-old Mick O'Connell.
And so to the heavyweights and the champion of 2 years ago in the red vest here, Mick O'Connell, representing the Royal Navy. But starting this second round against Nathan Thompson from the Wellington Club in Middlesbrough, 2 points down. Fairly quiet opening round with Mick O'Connell standing very upright, almost leaning back onto his right leg, waiting to see what Thompson had to offer. And the answer was plenty in that opening round, and Thompson was good for his 2 point lead.
Yeah, you'd expect O'Connell to start getting down to work now. He's waiting too long in the opening round. He needs to get his jab working and that right hand coming across. It's a little bit better.
Good stiff jab there from Thompson. 25 years of age, has had only 20 contests in his career so far, winning 13 of them. But starting brightly here, although we've seen on a number of occasions this evening that the more experienced of the two men has started slowly and come on strongly over the last couple of rounds in particular. And now now O'Connell trying to find his range with the left-hand jab, trying to break down Thompson and try to interrupt the rhythm that Thompson is getting into in this first minute and a half of the second round. The England number one at heavyweight is David Dolan, who's on duty at the World Championships at the moment. And it could be the subject of heavy debate as to who takes the heavyweight place when it comes to selection time for the Commonwealth Games in Melbourne in Australia in March. O'Connell in the shake-up, Anthony Bellew from Liverpool, who's in the second semi-final, and of course Dolan.
O'Connell's got to start stepping in here behind his punches. He's just starting to get picked off a little bit. He's waiting too long. He's got to start stepping in behind the shots.
So Nathan Thompson there leading by 4-0 against the champion of 2003, Mick O'Connell. And it's the cleaner single punches that have earned him that lead.
Nathan is 25. He's been boxing for 10 years. Boxes out of the Wellington ABC in Middlesbrough. Slip coach, John Dryden. Out of 20 matches so far, Nathan has won 13. The Boys Club finalist was his best result to date, but getting into the semi-finals of the 2005 ABAs here in Liverpool, I'm sure. It's his best attempt at glory so far. In the blue corner, from Middlesbrough, 25-year-old Nathan Thompson.
Mick O'Connell in the red vest and red headguard here is going to have to show some of the qualities that earned him the national title 2 years ago if he's to overturn this deficit against Nathan Thompson from the Wellington Club in Middlesbrough, who's been landing with solid single punches, nothing too fancy, not taking any risks, but often meeting Mick O'Connell on the way in. And O'Connell, as Robert McCracken has been saying earlier in the contest, needs to step in with more force behind these punches, because Thompson apparently is growing with confidence as the contest progresses.
Thompson's caught him with some nice shots here. O'Connell just standing outside too long, and Thompson's been catching him with little counters and meeting him as he comes in. O'Connell's got to do something to change the pattern of this fight.
A warning for holding for Nathan Thompson there from the referee, but that won't interrupt his flow. He's leading by 5-1 now here. And looking good value for that lead as well. Good work from Thompson, in particular with the straight punches, the jab and the right hand over the top. In particular, the jab has been his most successful punch so far, and one that O'Connell hasn't been able to measure and hasn't been able to counter up to now. Thompson with his high held guard, acres of space to the body, but Mick O'Connell is content to go headhunting here, and he's met with another stiff jab and knocked off balance. Impressive work with the jab here from Thompson.
Yeah, some nice punching from Thompson. Nice smooth boxing. Doesn't want to go reaching in, giving O'Connell a chance to catch him with a counter. But it's good work from Thompson.
And the lesson for O'Connell is being delivered right in front of him. Step in with a jab. He's flapping away there even at the end of that second round. Even at the end of that third round, should I say, and 7-1. It's a convincing lead for Nathan Thompson with just 2 minutes remaining.
Yeah, see, O'Connell needs to step in behind his punches, and that's why he's getting caught with the counters. He's got to step in behind his punches, but he's staying there all the time, and he's getting caught time and time again.
Fourth and final round.
Nathan Thompson in the predominantly black strip here and the blue head guard. He's been boxing well, virtually on the retreat for the first three rounds, and he's on the verge of completing what would be an upset here against the 2003 ABA national champion Mick O'Connell from the Navy in the red vest here. And O'Connell at the start of this final round, knowing he's trailing by 6 points, just getting a bit frustrated, but there may be a warning coming here for Nathan Thompson. And there is, it's a warning for holding, and that should mean under international rules that 2 points are added to the score of Mick O'Connell. Maybe now that will give him hope, that will close the gap to just 4 points. O'Connell now ploughing forward again. He's got to try and close this gap between the two men and on the scoreboard, because the long range left hands and overhand rights of Nathan Thompson have been the dominant factors so far.
This is better from O'Connell, but he's just got to get his hands working. You know, he's fiddling about with the jab standing on the outside, aren't going to get him any more points. He's just got to get in close, work the body, and then come over the top with the hooks.
There again, he's peppered with a light overhand right from Thompson, who really is finding his range with that. It's been very accurate all evening. This has been an impressive performance from the man from Middlesbrough, 25 years of age. He's been boxing for 10 years, but in that time has had only 20 contests. O'Connell's ploughing forward, forcing Thompson onto the ropes here. But the man from Middlesbrough unperturbed.
Yeah, this is suiting Thompson down to the ground. O'Connell's kind of stood outside for the whole three and a half rounds, and Thompson just picked him on and picked him off and enjoyed himself. O'Connell should have gone on top of Thompson from the start and turned it into more of a fight than a boxing match, because it would have suited him.
The stronger, stiffer punching has come from Nathan Thompson, and it's been enough for him to score a surprise victory over the man from the Navy, Mick O'Connell, champion 2 years ago, but second best on this occasion as they work away in furious flurries inside. But for Mick O'Connell, it's going to be a case of too little too late. And there's the bell and the seal on a terrific victory for Nathan Thompson from the Wellington Club in Middlesbrough, safely through to the heavyweight final. So Nathan Thompson, in a sense, coming of age with that victory there over the champion in 2003, Mick O'Connell, and he's through to the final at 91 kilograms at heavyweight.
Thanks, Don.
This is Matt.
Hi, Nathan.
Sorry. How are you, mate? Well done.
We could just jump in front there.
Can I talk to you?
Yeah.
Can I come in?
No, talk to me.
All right.
Nathan, congratulations. Good win. You've beaten a former champion there. Do you fancy your chances now of taking the title yourself?
Yeah, I do, yeah. I haven't boxed for 3 years, so it's just last night the fight, I just had to get a bit of rust out. I felt a lot better tonight.
You haven't boxed for 3 years?
3 years since the last time I boxed.
Yeah. 3 years was the last time you boxed before tonight?
Yeah, no, from before last night, but I was a bit rusty last night.
That's an amazing performance considering you've had such a time away from the ring. What's been the reason for that? Injury or just change of course?
Bit of injury, and then I just thought, I'm 25 now, so I thought it's getting a bit on for an amateur. So, but then my sister's husband, he's a boxing coach for the army. He got me back into it, so I feel a lot good now.
Sounds like he did a good thing because you're in the ABA finals, yeah, taking place in London next month, and you could become champion.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Okay, well, it may be an unexpected title if you get it, but well deserved, and congratulations.
Hey, thank you. Thanks a lot.
Nice one, mate. Good stuff. Cheers. Yeah, I've boxed for 3 years.
Oh, nice.
In the red corner, David Reed, who's 26, from Portsmouth. Dave has been boxing for 5 years out of the city of Portsmouth, ABC. His coach, Ted Harris. Dave has won 5 out of the 7 bouts and has won the Southern Counties title twice. In the red corner, from the city of Portsmouth, 26-year-old Dave Reed.
Echo newspaper described them as the Magnificent Seven, and all 6 of Liverpool's representatives here so far this evening have won through to the ABA finals. And Anthony Bellew, representing the Rotunda Club here in the black and gold colours with the blue headguard, is looking to make it a clean sweep, and he leads by just that single point after the first round against David Reed from the City of Portsmouth Club in the red headguard and red gloves, and behind whom there's plenty of confidence here. Half a dozen or so of his supporters sat just behind us at ringside. We're looking to get a bet on earlier on, so confident were they of their man causing an upset here against Bellew in the black there, who's won the title for the last 2 years.
Reed very aggressive at the moment. It's the right tactics from him. He's got to try and put Bellew out of his stride. Working at the moment. And there he goes again, bundling out of his stride.
and Reed gets to work as Bellew is forced onto the ropes over by the neutral corner, far side of the ring, and the referee just breaks them. And the usual command to take a step back before starting boxing again. And Bellew here has got his work cut out to progress any further on the march towards what he hopes will be a hat-trick of ABA heavyweight titles. For much of the contest so far, Bellew has been happy to go on the back foot, but he does seem to be having success when he pushes Reed back. But again, flicks out the jab and lands as Reed comes winging forward, and so the gap increases to a couple of points.
See, Bellew's a real good fighter. He's getting his time and his room now, and he'll pick Reed if he can. As Reed's got to do what his corner told him and keep the pressure on and not give him the room to do that.
Bellew putting plenty of distance between himself and the big punching man from Portsmouth, taking no chances, playing it safe, flicking out the jab. That's all he needs to do to progress to the ABA finals for the third year in succession. And at the moment, everything is going to plan for Anthony Bellew.
In the blue corner, Tony Bellew, Tony from Liverpool, boxing out of the Rotunda Club. Tony's 22. He's had 31 bouts and won 29, and has been the ABA champion twice. At this weight, of course. In the blue corner, from the Rotunda, representing Liverpool, 22-year-old Tony Bellew.
Tony Bellew in the black and gold colours here with the blue headguard, aiming for a third successive ABA national title at heavyweight. Although he's far from safe at this stage, he did look to be moving into a very comfortable position by the close of the second round. Neat counter-punching, dominating virtually with one hand, the left jab solid and accurate as David Reed from the city of Portsmouth ploughs forward, trying to look for the big punch that might turn the contest his way.
Yeah, Reed's allowing Bellew too much time and space. Bellew can set him up now as he comes in. Reed's got to go back to his early stuff, getting on top and closing the gap and making it untidy. If he stands off boxing with Bellew, he'll come off second best.
And Bellew took a bit of a risk there, trying to throw a right uppercut, was nearly caught by an overhand right from Reed at the same time. He's just got to be a bit careful as Bellew, no need to take any chances here. He's got the lead he needs. And he's heading towards the ABA final for the third year in a row. And again, Reed does look perturbed when he's pushed onto the back foot, but it seems Bellew is happy to stay on the back foot himself.
Yeah, Bellew's content because he wants the room and time and he wants to catch Reed coming in. What Reed needs to do is be far more aggressive, get on top of Bellew and just turn it into a hooking contest, basically.
Turn it into a slugfest.
Because if he stands and boxes with Bellew, he's going to come off second best, like I said.
And that's the situation at the moment. Second best by 2 points, David Reed, who's had, believe it or not, only 7 contests in his career. Been boxing for 5 years. He's won 5 of those. And unless he can produce something pretty sensational here, then he's going to be losing another one. Good work from Bellew. Good footwork as well as with the hands. Neatly turned his man once he was in the corner, and then suddenly he swiveled and Reed was there too. So 2 points in it for Anthony Bellew, champion for the past 2 years. And this could be a very interesting last round for the champion.
91 kgs and in the red corner from the city of Portsmouth.
Yeah, Bellew just needs a space and time to get his work going. That's better from Reed, where he closes the gap. He caught him with a nice right hook over the top. He's just got to keep it up and he's got to do more of it.
Twice times ABA champion. He's 22, he's Tony Bellew. Fourth and final round.
2 minutes to go, and what can David Reed in the silvery grey vest here and the red head guard do to turn this one around and produce what would be the best win of his career so far? Only 7 fights on his log, but he's been boxing here like a man much more experienced, although he's come off second best so far against Anthony Bellew of the Rotunda Club in Liverpool, who's won this heavyweight title for the last 2 years in a row and has been doing just enough to stay in front over the course of the first 3 rounds of this contest, the first 6 minutes.
Yeah, you'd never know that Reed had had just a handful of bouts. You know, sometimes we can sound a little bit harsh criticising them for not being too aggressive, but a fantastic job to be competing at this level after 7 fights. And you had to got to go off to his club, you know. Bellew from the other club, Rotunda, one of the best clubs in Britain, ABA champions galore. So, you know, it's a good achievement from Portsmouth and from the Portsmouth boxer.
Certainly good pedigree emerging from the Rotunda gym, because they've got 2 men already through to the finals from this evening's contest, and now Bellew hoping to make it a threesome. But Reed is fighting to the end here with 45 seconds to go in this final round. He's just a point behind, pushing forward, probing, looking for the opening, but he takes 2 good shots back from Bellew now, who's on the attack suddenly, trying to secure his title. Suddenly he realizes that it was hanging by a thread, and so now he comes back.
Good work from Bellew there with the right hand, but full credit to Reed. He won't be perturbed. He keeps backing him up, keeps going in with them right hands and left hooks now. But there's Bellew again. That's why he's the champion, because he just manages to find the room for the rook for the counters.
Bellew's attitude, clearly, if you want to take my title, you've got to produce more than this. But he sticks out the jab, does Reed. Is that going to be enough to turn the tide his way? There's still 2 points in it. We're into the closing seconds of the final round, and Bellew must have done just enough to hang on here. He's looking across anxiously at some of his supporters outside the ring. There's just 1 point between Bellew and Reed. Can Reed close it down? He can't. There goes the bell at the end of one of the best contests of the entire evening. And by the skin of his teeth, Anthony Bellew is through to the ABA finals for the 3rd year in a row.
Fantastic fight. What a good effort from the Portsmouth boxer to lose on such a narrow margin.
And here was David Reed trying to the end, landed a good stiff jab, but then left himself open to the counter from Anthony Bellew. It was all getting pretty desperate from both sides at this stage. 2-punch combination from Bellew, showing his championship experience towards the end of that round. And David Reed, for a man who's had only 7 contests, produced there the performance of his career. Well, in a sense, there were 2 winners here this evening. This man, David Reed, from the city of Portsmouth, will come on bundles for that performance here this evening. But on this occasion, second best to the defending champion.
The result of bout number 17, with a point score of 9-7, the winner, Bellew, in the blue corner. Showing appreciation for both boxers.
Bellew through to the final, and the group described as the Magnificent Seven by the Liverpool Echo newspaper, all safely through to the ABA finals in 2 weeks' time. Thank
Thanks.
You.
Cheers.
Boxes to the ring, please.
A reminder, by the way, that all the highlights from tonight's championships on Sky Channel 111 next Saturday, a week on Saturday at 6:30.